Just because Josiah was a doctor didn't mean that he couldn't get sick himself. Josiah came down with a fever that threatened his very life, and no treatments were working, and the prospects weren't looking good for our young doctor. Until...
Josiah Bartlett.
Josiah Bartlett.
Josiah Bartlett.
Josiah Bartlett was born on November 21st, 1729, in Amesbury, Massachusetts. From a very early age, Josiah was a clever boy, and by the age of 16, he had already learned Greek and Latin. This served him quite well as he apprenticed under a local doctor for the next 5 years. Finally feeling confident enough to start on his own practice in Kingston, New Hampshire at the age of just 21. But just because Josiah was a doctor didn't mean that he couldn't get sick himself. 2 years after establishing his own practice, Josiah came down with a fever that threatened his very life. No treatments were working and the prospects weren't looking good for the young doctor. As the final attempt at treatment, or maybe just because he was thirsty, Josiah asked those caring for him to bring him cider every couple of hours. Miraculously, the treatment worked, and Josiah made a full and complete recovery. And from this experience, Josiah began to value alternative cures to the common illnesses. In 1754, shortly after, Josiah married his wife, Mary Bartlett. Kingston was struck with a terrible disease. This sickness affected the throat and the lungs and swept through the community like a plague, sending many to their graves. Without an effective treatment, Josiah remembered his previous experience with alternative solutions. He quickly began brainstorming what might be possible cures for this mysterious disease. Josiah tried Peruvian bark, or quinine, on a patient of his and found it yielded great results. His newfound cure became the general remedy of diseases similar to this one. In 1765, Josiah was elected to the legislature of New Hampshire. He was also appointed by the royal governor to the office of Justice of the Peace for the king. But he still opposed British authority. He accepted the position, but was firm in his opposition to the royal governor, as he had always been. His firm patriotic attitude was, well, obnoxious to the governor, and the governor eventually terminated the entire royal government in New Hampshire. In early July of 1776, Dr. Bartlett took his seat in the Continental Congress. It was agreed to begin with the northernmost colonies for the voting on the great issue of independence, and Josiah Bartlett had the honor of being called upon first from New Hampshire to give his vote in favor of independence. 2 days later, he was able to sign the Declaration of Independence on the 4th of July, 1776, at the age of 46. In 1779, New Hampshire was a mess. The money was depreciated and the provisions were scarce and they cost a fortune. Indian corn was $10 a bushel and other necessities were equally as expensive. Soldiers couldn't even survive on their wages. Josiah was appointed to several high offices in the following years, since his advice was invaluable to the colony in addressing these issues. In January of 1794, Josiah finally closed his public career with this letter to the legislature. "Gentlemen of the legislature, after having served the public for a number of years to the best of my abilities, in the various offices to which I have had the honor to be appointed, I think it proper, before your adjournment, to signify to you and through you to my fellow citizens at large that I now find myself so far advanced in age that it will be expedient for me at the close of the session to retire from the cares and fatigue of public business to the repose of a private life with a grateful sense of the repeated marks of trust and confidence that my fellow citizens have reposed in me, and with my best wishes for the future peace and prosperity of the state. Well, Josiah wasn't able to enjoy his retirement for too long, since he died just a year later, May 19th, 1795, at the age of 66. Charles Augustus Goodrich writes of Josiah, "His patriotism was a singularly elevated character, and the sacrifices which he made for the good of his country were such as few men were willing to make. He possessed a quick and a penetrating mind, and, at the same time, he was distinguished for a sound and accurate judgment." So, remember, when you get sick, liquids every couple of hours was the miraculous treatment that worked for Josiah, who made a full recovery. Taking care of yourself and using these alternative cures has been the way our family deals with sickness for the most part. And signer Dr. Benjamin Rush saved his patients in Philadelphia with bloodletting, cool air, cold drinks, strict diet, and soaking in cold water. Good health!